Hello guys, Dan here. In today's video, we will paint this Hasatsu Nayar, and I will show you how to paint his camo hoodie as well as this little brick wall under him and do decorations on his cape. I just need to add that this model is very difficult to paint, especially like he has so many places that are not accessible. So I would suggest you to paint it unassembled, not like me, because I struggled a lot during the paint session. As usual, we will base our model with the red foam spray as a primer, and then I choose to start with his metal parts. So I will start with the black Templar contrast color, and I will paint all his pipings on the legs and his weapon as well. Try to be as neat as possible, but yeah, as I told you before, it's very difficult to access some of his parts, so there will be a paint splatter all over the place. After Black Templar is dry, we will use the red bone as a razor, and then go around the model and clean all the places when we unnecessarily painted black and that we actually don't want them to be black, just to prepare the model for the next color, because our next color will be bright color, and if it is black under, it will stain a lot. For his armor panels and the cape, we will use Agaron's Dunes contrast color, and we will go all around the model, but we will do a panel by panel. So just take a paint on your brush and put it on one panel, and then don't allow it to pull up, just move it around into the recesses and leave the flat panels without the color. Try to be neat, but in this moment, if you have a little stains on some other pieces like his holster and his stripes on his legs, it's fine. For his cape, try to avoid pulling of colors at the bottom of the cape, because it will tend to pull there. Just dry your brush and clear the excess paint, and then come back in a couple of seconds and do it again. Don't allow to make a big pull marks like you see here in the right corner. Now it's time to use the Crit Camo. This is a great paint to do the camo. It's very weird to use, so you need to go back like a couple of times when it's dried and then apply it again. So just apply the first coat, thin coat of the Crit Camo, and then continue doing painting the model. And then when the paint is almost dry, come back again and then just go around a little, and then keep doing something else. So when it's dry again, you come back again and do another layer. You will see me coming from time to time back to this color and adding another thin coat until I get the pattern I like on his hood. So I will paint the rims of his shoes and the holsters over the Agaron's Dunes, and this color when applied over the Agaros dunes will give you a really nice shade of camo green. And as well, on his holster you see that there is a little red bone under it, an Agaros dunes, so it will create a really nice like shade of camo. So just do a nice putting coats. Now we need to paint his cloak after the previous layer is dry, so we will use a snake biliter and just cover the whole cloak with one thin layer of this contrast paint. The same principle as before, try not to allow the big poolings of paint at the bottom of your cape. So while this part is getting dry, it's time to paint his magazine. I just like to paint the magazine in the silver color, so I will use lead belcher, and then I will make later like some bluish tint adding to it. And when that is dried, just wash it with some noon oil. So the last part that we didn't paint on the miniature is his backpack. We will use a contrast color or flash. Straight from the pot, just add a little on your brush and just spread it evenly around the backpack. Now it's time to draw his lines on the cape, so I will use the Warbler's Green. We dilute this color on the palette so it flows nicely from my brush, and then I will just draw the three really thick lines around his back of his cape. Just be patient and go section by section, and you will have to do this in 3-14 coats. So draw one line, wait it to dry, meanwhile draw another line, and then draw the third one, and then you can go back to the first one, reinforce it, and just do that a couple of times until you get the perfect color of your lines. After you're happy with your lines, we will use crit camo again, and we will go back and shade those lines, use it as a like a wash. And I will use this moment as well to do another pass on his hood. But I won't go all over the hood, just on the sunspots so I can create like a pattern for his game camo. After your hood is completely dried, it's time to start highlighting it. So we will start with a scarsting green. Just take a little on your paintbrush and go just over the edges of the hood and over those folds, just on the top areas. Leave everything else as intact as it is. And you can do at this moment as well. You can see how I got nice patterns on the camo, so I will use the brightest one and just reinforce it a little with the color. Start applying this color to his backpack, but this time it doesn't need to be the edge highlight, so you can cover more parts of this backpack, but leave the most deepest recesses and places that you want to be in the shadow, leave them in the with the previous color. So while those paints are settling down, I will use Warbler's green and I will start highlighting the stripes on his cape. So I will follow the folds on his capes and I will just highlight the most raised areas. And I will go around multiple thin coats as well with the thin color. We'll just give it a time to dry and then come back again and do another layer until you are satisfied how your lines look like. And as well, I will use the same color to highlight his boots and the stripes for the holsters. Now I will mix like 70% of the scarsting green and 30% of Ethereal Yellow and create a nice highlight color. So this will be used for his backpack for edge highlighting, and as well you can highlight his holster and the stripes with the one final highlight. For the metal and the black parts, we will use Administratum Grey. So we will just edge highlight his gun, and I will go around the model and all those little tubings on his armor. Just do a little dot highlight or just little lines on top of it, so they just get like a third dimension. For the magazine, we will now add a little glaze of the Gilliam Blue which will just create some bluish metal look. Time to go back to the cape when it's dried. So we will use a steel legend wrap and we will go over the cape and start adding a layer of it as a highlight. After this layer is dry, we will use Zandri dust as our final highlight color for the cape. And just go over the most raised area of the folds and just add a little lines. So you will have to go two thin coats to have a nice consistency of the color. And as well, go around the edges of the cape and just draw little lines. So after our glaze is dried on his magazine, we will use a store hot sealer just as a edged highlight. Yeah, our model is almost done. So one of the last things that we need to do is to highlight all his armor panels. So we will use the Flate 1 Flash. We will apply this paint as our edge highlight. So go around all of his panels and highlight every single edge and the fold of the armors. Just be patient and go around. This is like a very long process. The more of these things you do, the more they will look nicer. At this moment, we need to go back to his cape and paint these little cables. So I will base them the Raidbone color and just wait for that color to dry, and then we will come back to it after. While this part is drying, I will use my time to paint that little brick wall. So I will just base it with a squid orange. Just add a solid amount of water to the color so it flows really nicely, so it can go in all the recesses of these bricks, and just base the whole wall. after this little wall is drying, I will go back to the cables again. I will use a contrast black Templar color and just apply one nice thin coat. To shade the wall, we will use a Seraphim Sepia. Just be generous with this wash and add it just in all recess areas and all around. And it will take around 20 minutes for this wash to be completely dried before we can continue to the next step. So meanwhile, while I'm waiting for that, I will go back to his cables on the back of his cape and just highlight them. And same as before, I will use Administratum Grey to highlight the black parts. And to do the final highlight, I will use the Screaming Skull and I will only highlight it his mask. While our little wall is dried, so we will just dry brush it using the Kizler Flash. So side to side motion and go around it until you get a really nice paint build up on these little bricks. So time to transfer him to his base and this model will be finished. I already prepared these bases for my rest of my army, and this base quite don't match this little brick wall, but I transferred it anyway, so you can have a look how does it look. I hope you enjoyed this video. It was a little messy, but if you like it, please make a comment, like and subscribe, and see you guys in the next one. Bye bye.